My hoodie is so on point today because this video is literally an unedited version of my life. Hi, what's up you guys? Welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to another video of Vlogmas 2020 and I'm so happy with the response and the love y'all have been showing on every single one of my videos. I literally want to like hug you all in person and thank you all for all the love y'all show me in the comments. I literally read all the comments before going to sleep at night. I may not be able to respond to each and every one of y'all, but know that I'm seeing. I love you all and thank you for every single one of those comments. It means the world to me. For today's video, this is something I had been planning, that one video has to be a super personal heart-to-heart sort of a video. So I took some personal questions on my community tab as well as on my Instagram, and I'm gonna mix them up and answer them for y'all today. It's gonna be a really personal video where I tap into a lot of questions that y'all have about my family, about my career, about my everything, my childhood, my religious backgrounds and whatnot. There is so many type of questions here, so go grab a snack and then let's dive into this. The first question I have here asks, how much do you spend every month on yourself on an average? So if you mean this question, like overall, like I do bear my complete expense, my personal expense myself. I don't take money from my parents anymore. So if I'm bearing my complete expense, I like from everything, right? From travel to my going out and eating with my friends and my social life to my investment in my channel and everything, comes out to be 30 to 35,000. It's not just mine, it's also Fudge's. So because doctor ki kharche bhi hote hai, I take daily medications and Fudge also has to go to the doctor and everything. So not just mine and Fudge's comes up to be that much. The next question says, one advice you'd love to give your younger self. So I am pretty young myself. There isn't much I want to say to my teenage self, but I feel like I always felt this hollowness in my teenage self because I never had friends for life types. You know, some people just make friends in school in early on and they stay with them forever. Early in my school age, I did not have a lot of friends because I was like the goody good, you know, teacher's pet sort of a. I didn't want to be that person, but I was that person because I used to score well and I study well and I was the head girl and everything. So I didn't have a lot of friends early on in my school days, but later on in 10th standard, I made friends who are still friends with me. So maybe my earlier school days, I would want to tell myself that don't stress a lot that you don't have a lot of friends. It's fine. Eventually, you're going to have friends who are going to stay with you forever and add to your life more meaningfully than ever. So yeah, maybe that would be an advice I would want to give myself. Okay, the next question says, doctor and tattoos, is it allowed? So there is no such specific rule. I know a lot of medicos who do get tattoos, but I don't think clinically it's very professional to have like tattoo sleeves and like huge tattoos which show very much. So I try to get tattoos which can be concealed in clothing. Like if I wear full sleeves, you can't see any of my tattoos. Everything is concealed within the space of my body. And anything that's external is so minimalistic that it does not look disturbing or looks very unprofessional. So that is why I'm very much into minimalistic tattoos. I'm not really into those crazy, very big tattoos so that it looks professional, but I also get what I want. Would you ever move out? So this is a good question. I think I would definitely one day in life move out. I do want to get out of the comfort zone of my home because honestly speaking, I'm a very pampered child. I get everything to my room. Because I'm the younger one in the family, I am very, very spoiled when it comes to anything, and I'm not even going to like sugarcoat it, because even though my parents have taught me everything and like, you know, to work hard and the value of money and everything, they've also never deprived me of anything. They've always given me everything that I've wanted, alhamdulillah, and sometimes it gets a little too comfortable. So of course, I want to break out of my shell one day, and my mom also always tells me this, that someday I think you should break out of your shell and, you know, explore. So we always have this conversation that one day I would move out and, you know, try to explore life on my own. I'm just 21, so that's going to be far off in the future, but I definitely consider it one day because I don't always want to remain in the shell of my parents and having Choto at my beck and call and everything, because they have worked very hard to get here. So I want to be able to work hard in some way and some way, you know, experience the actual bruntness of life, jahan khud sab karna padta hai, har cheez khud se karna padta hai, where you come home and you don't get everything in your room, you know. So yeah, maybe someday I want to experience that. It's just like an adventure of life. Okay, the next question is about, why did you break up with your long distance boyfriend? So if you all don't know, I was dating somebody at the beginning of 2020. It was not a very long relationship, but it was my first proper relationship. It went on for 6 months, but throughout the course of the relationship, it was a long distance one. It like, we never really dated when we were in the same country or city. We dated only when it went long distance. So it got a little too difficult when it comes to communication and keeping up. And when you're really not settled in your mental space of mind, personally, both of us weren't, because we are just 21, 22. So that kind of got in the way ke baar baar, you know, jhagde hote the usi baat pe, and it used to mess up with our personal life to the point that it got so toxic ki agar hum thoda bhi aur usko continue karte na, hum khush hi nahi the. Matlab, both of us were not happy, and both of us were like first friends to each other. So just for the sake of our happiness, our mutual happiness, we were like, we called it off mutually ke nahi ho raha hai boss. And maybe sometimes you just have to take that call. Of course, it hurts and it is difficult to move on from, but it is always healthy. And now that I look back at it, I'm so glad that happened, because you evolve, move on, and grow so much as a person from every experience you have and every person you meet. So yeah, it taught me a lot. Next question asks, who is your inspiration in the family? So my parents are my biggest inspiration. Like, I have looked up to my parents all my life because they have had the worst hardships in life. Like, it's not even my story to tell because it's my parents' life. But I know for a fact that they have successfully moved in life from living in a chawl to living in a 2BHK apartment in one of the very posh areas of Bombay, and that is a success in itself. Like, you can just imagine the hardship. It took them 30 years to get here, but they did it together. They worked very, very hard. They had no backing whatsoever. They didn't come from very wealthy backgrounds. They did not have much, but they made everything together. And there have been like ups and downs. Like, if I listen to their story, it gives me goosebumps, like literally goosebumps. Sometimes I listen to them and I'm like, how have you humanly possibly come out of such times? Because in today's age, if you even think about it na, wo possible nahi hoga. Aisi cheeze they have seen and come out of it. So, I mean, I have so much respect for my parents, and I've always, always looked up to them as inspiration, because I know that when times were hard also, they've never really said no to us as children. They've been able to give us everything. Like, I know when they've not had things and been like, haan, theek hai, kar lo, haan, theek hai. Like, kuch bhi deprive nahi kiya humko, alhamdulillah. And they've given us so much. Just because, like, one thing my mom always used to say is, humko nahi mila, to tumko milna chahiye. You know, like, that was her motto all her life. And yeah, my parents are my biggest inspiration. Okay, the next question asks, where do you see yourself in 20 years? Oh my god, 20 years is such a far-fetched thing. If you know me at all, I believe in one day at a time. I literally take life as it comes, because I have been in that headspace where I used to plan itna future ka. And fir, you know, life waisa nahi hota hai. When you plan and then it does not happen the way you want it to, it really hurts. And you feel very like, you know, as if your world is crumbling down, when actually kuch aur bahut acha ho sakta hai ya ho raha hai, but you can't focus on that. So maine bahut pehle life mein seekh liya hai ki, you know, you focus on jo hai abhi hai aapke paas and make the most of that, which is what I do. If you ever like notice, I will make the most of the 24 hours I have in front of me. Baki kuch nahi, aage ka itna nahi sochti hu. But in 20 years, definitely 20 years, matlab I'll be what, 41? Definitely I hope shaadi ho gayi ho, bacche bhi ho gaye ho, aur 4-5 kutte to definitely hone chahiye. And definitely want a house that has a swimming pool. At least a building that has a swimming pool. Yaar, ye building mein swimming pool nahi hai. I'm such a water baby. I definitely want a swimming pool. This is a very good question. She asks me, like, since your parents were from two different religions, what kind of relationship you had with your paternal grandparents? How you handled both the religions? This is a very good question, because I think meri puri zindagi has been like a kind of a confused state when it comes to what I identify as religiously, because like, even though on book, on paper, I am a Muslim because my father is a Muslim and officially I am that, I've never very strongly felt connected to just one religion, because I was grown up in a household where my mom is a Catholic, I was from a convent school, so I learned all those ways and techniques and everything. And of course, my dad was a Muslim, he taught us everything, and my dadi taught us everything, so wo bhi sikha. Matlab, dono seekhte hue bade hue, so can't really identify myself as one, which is why I don't identify myself anymore as a proper religion, because I don't feel the need to. I'm a human beyond and above everything. So pura bachpan, I think that confusion has definitely been there when it comes to grandparents. Like, abhi matlab mom and dad are very chill when it comes to this. Pehle of course aisa tha ke, you know, follow this, but ab jab bade ho gaye, they have also become very chill about it ke ab tum bade ho gaye ho, tumko dekh lo, tumko jo karna hai, tumko jo sahi lage types ho gaya hai. But grandparents are grandparents yaar, unko nahi wo matlab, you can't expect them. There's a very big generation gap. They were brought up in those times where religious practices, everything is everything to them. That is their life and everything. I don't really have grandfathers on both sides. I only have dadi and nani. तो नानी के घर जाओ तो इट्स लाइक यू नो यू प्रे टू जीसस यू आर द होली चाइल्ड ऑफ दैट हाउस एंड इफ यू आर अराउंड दादी देन इट्स लाइक नमाज पढ़ो ये करो तो अब मतलब दोनों को खुश रखना है बिकॉज आई लव माई नानी एंड आई लव माई दादी सो आई डोंट वांट टू अपसेट देम बाय टेलिंग देम कि मैं ऐसा सोचती हूँ मैं वैसा सोचती हूँ दैट इज अ कॉन्वर्सेशन दैट विल नेवर हैव एन एंड तो मैं वो करती नहीं हूँ सो दैट इज हाउ आई डील विद माई ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स बट आई बिलीव इन गॉड एज अ होल ओनली आई विल लिटरली प्रे टू एनी सिंगल गॉड एंड In my daily prayers, I say both my rosary as well as my kalma and I also say namaz and I also keep roza and I also celebrate Christmas. So yeah, that is my life in a literal nutshell. Okay, the next question says, how did you think of choosing medical field and what exactly is occupational therapy? So, medical is something I've always wanted to do. I have always taken interest in biology, in anatomy, in human body. It वेरी मच इंटरेस्टेड मी जब से मैं छोटी थी मुझे वही करना था एंड माई पेरेंट्स आर वेरी रियलिस्टिक वो लोग ऐसे नहीं है कि हाँ हाँ बेटा तू तो डॉक्टर ही बनेगी देवर लाइक बनना है तो बहुत मेहनत करनी पड़ेगी तो मैंने बचपन से बहुत मेहनत की है टू बी एबल टू गेट योर यू नो पढ़ाई में ऑल्सो आई शू लाइक ऑलवेज वर्क हार्ड बिकॉज आई शू थिंक फर्स्ट स्टैंडर्ड के मार्क्स भी काउंट हो गए आगे जाके तो आई शू ऑलवेज ट्राई टू वर्क हार्ड एंड एक्सेल इन माई स्टडीज टू बी एबल टू वन डे रीच दैट मार्क वेर आई कैन टेक मेडिकल Now, occupational therapy is something, initially, मुझे भी इतना idea नहीं था. I was also in that whole bubble of, oh, MBBS, MBBS, MBBS. But when I could not do it because of my health, if you all know, if you all have seen any of my personal vlogs, you all know I have fibromyalgia. This happened only during my entrance exam and because of that, मैं अच्छे से exam नहीं दे पाई थी. बहुत बहुत बीमार थी. Like, I literally got up from my bed, from bed rest, went, gave my exam and came back. एंड वापस सो गई थी मतलब इतनी दवाइयों पर जाके मैंने ऐसा ड्रग्ड स्टेट में एग्जाम दिया है तो भी अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह से 140 ऑन 20 आया मुझे बिकॉज मैंने पहले बहुत मेहनत की थी एग्जाम के लिए सो बिकॉज आई गॉट दोज मार्क्स आई वॉन्ट टू एक्सप्लोर एंड सी वॉट आर माई ऑप्शन बिकॉज आई डिंट वॉन्ट टू गिव दैट होल एंट्रेंस ऑल ओवर अगेन यू एवर प्रिपेयर फॉर नीट और सी टी यू नो हाउ टॉर्चरस इट इज टू गो थ्रू दैट होल प्रोसीजर इट्स वेरी वेरी ग्रोसम सो दैट इज वाई आई डिंट वॉन्ट टू पुट माई सेल्फ थ्रू दैट एंड बिकॉज आई हैड अ डिजीज दैट डज नॉट हैव अ क्योर सो दैट इज वाई आई वॉज लाइक ऐसा कुछ लेते हैं दैट इज नॉट टू स्ट्रेसफुल बट इज स्टिल यू नो क्लोज टू माई liking is close to what I dreamt of becoming so I searched up and I looked up and there were options in the rehab team so my options were physiotherapy occupational therapy and speech therapy aur bhi bahut options hote hain you should really research usme se physiotherapy I didn't want to do because I was interested in pediatrics mujhe bachchon mein bahut interest hai mujhe wahi karna tha MBBS mein bhi I want to do pediatrics so I was like you know physiotherapy is not offering me that to maine wo list mein bhara hi nahi tha Then was occupational therapy and speech therapy has a lot of scope, which is why I filled these two. Now, occupational therapy is basically in very general terms a rehabilitation. When it comes to pediatrics, we deal with children who have Down syndrome, autism, and when it comes to adults, also there are a lot of specialties. There's neurology, psychiatry, but the both options in occupational therapy. Just to give you a very vague example, अगर आप stroke के patient को जानते हो like एक side पूरा आपका weak हो जाता है आप घर के काम नहीं कर सकते खुद के काम नहीं कर सकते and you of course can't go back to work. So we not only help you rehabilitate, get your strength back, but also make sure that you can do those activities again. तो हम आपके घर के काम से ही आपको rehabilitate करने में help करते हैं आपके actual job profile से ही आपको rehabilitate करने की कोशिश करते हैं and then make you go back to your work. So we'll be with you from the time you get discharged to the hospital till the time you go back to work. That is the whole spectrum of it and there's a lot to it I can't really like it's a video for another day but that's the gist of it your take on dealing with insecurities so I've had a lot of insecurities kafi cheezon ki like confidence nahi tha life mein skin pe bahut acne the jab youtube shuru kiya tha tabhi bhi bahut acne the I was not the ideal body size. I was really chubby and because I'm tall, I was also overweight and I was not the ideal body in any way. Because I'm tall also, I have been shamed so much. Like more than my body fat and my acne, I think meri height pe kitna shaming hua hai. Bachpan se, like of course, main hamesha se lambi thi. Hamesha classroom mein sabse lambi thi. हमेशा एक डायलॉग सुना या तो लड़का नहीं मिलेगा शादी के लिए या तो इतनी लंबी है तो लाइन के पीछे चलेगा लाइक द थिंग्स पीपल से इन स्कूल एंड एट वेडिंग्स आई हैव हैड सच मोमेंट्स एट लाइक देयर वाज वंस दिस टाइम एट अ वेडिंग कि मैं इतनी इरिटेट हो गई थी ना सबके बोलने से कि लड़का नहीं मिलेगा लाइक आई वाज ओनली 11 और 12 और तुम 11 12 साल की बच्ची को बोल रहे हो कि उसको शादी के लिए लड़का नहीं मिलेगा एंड ऑल्सो बिकॉज आई एम द टॉलेस्ट अमंगस्ट ऑल माई सिस्टर्स ऑल्सो द यंगेस्ट तो जिसमें सबसे छोटी है बट सबसे लंबी है इसकी तो पहले करवा दो शादी वरना लड़का नहीं मिलेगा ओ माई गॉड आई हिट अ पॉइंट वेर मैं घर आके इतना रोई थी एंड आई टोल्ड माई पेरेंट्स मैं वापस कोई शादी में नहीं जा रही हूँ उसके बाद से कसम खा के मैंने कोई शादी में नहीं गई हूँ कोई भी फैमिली की शादी में नहीं गई हूँ आई हैव जस्ट लाइक like said goodbye to all my family members. Like दूर के रिश्तेदार तो bye bye, मुझे नहीं आना तुम्हारी शादियों में. तुम्हारी शादियों में आके मुझे यही सुनने मिलता है तो मुझे नहीं सुनना. तो इसलिए I sit at my house only. I don't go anywhere unless it's like really really close family. I don't attend weddings only anymore. So yeah, coming back to the question, dealing with insecurities, I've not always dealt with it the very strong way you'll see me on camera. मेरे भी moments रहे, बहुत रोई हूँ, काफी insecurities के साथ deal किया up and down. But eventually I think the end result is you have to face it, do something about it. Like when it came to my weight, I started exercising, started eating clean, made a difference. When it came to my acne, went to the dermat, started taking medicines. So when you know ki ha, you are on the path of getting better, you will feel confident ki ha, I will get better. You feel a little hopeful, right? Rakshita asks, do you plan to get any more pets? Not really. Like Fudge was also something that I speculated for really really long. It's very very hectic to take care of a dog. As much as I love Fudge, I want to be able to give him all my attention, and Fudge is not very friendly with other dogs. Like usko nahi pasand hai, to usko dukhi karke I will not get another pet. So I'm happy Fudge ki ek hi, mera ek hi bachcha hai, wohi main khush hu. Ladka nahi mila but bachcha to hai. Okay, I am Nandini asks, does it ever feel too hectic having two jobs, or do you enjoy it? By the way, lots of love to you too, Nandini. It doesn't feel very hectic for now, because abhi tak main student thi, ab mera internship shuru hoga, ab I'm actually going to be a working professional. Student ho na to kafi lectures bunk kar sakte hai, kafi time lectures cancel ho jate hai, ghar jaldi aa jate hai, aur you know padhai apne hisab se kar sakti hu, apne time ke hisab se kar sakti hu, YouTube apne time ke hisab se kar sakti hu. Now best part about YouTube is that main abhi bhi use apne time ke hisab se kar sakti hu. It's my thing, I can modulate it according to me, and alhamdulillah I'm in a space that I can like hire help if I need to, which I definitely do. Like abhi Vlogmas mein bhi itna kaam ho gaya tha 25 videos ka, so I did delegate work to editors so that mera kaam thoda halka ho jaye. So I think with time I will evolve and see what works best for me. Hectic to hota hai, but I really enjoy it and I really love it. I'm very passionate about everything that I do, and like पूरे दिल से करती हूँ तो मुझे बहुत मजा आता है. तो इवन अगर मैं थक जाऊँ रात को तो चल जाता है. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, हाउ डिड यू इन्वेस्ट इन द इनिशियल मेकअप एंड इक्विपमेंट बिफोर यू स्टार्टेड मेकिंग मनी? दिस इज अ रियली गुड क्वेश्चन. सो आई यूज़ली हैड 5,000 पॉकेट मनी मंथली टू बी एबल टू बेयर ऑल माई एक्सपेंसेज व्हेन इट केम टू गोइंग आउट विद माई फ्रेंड्स, मेरे फ्रेंड्स के बर्थडे गिफ्ट, मेरे बर्थडे गिफ्ट, कुछ भी खरीदना हो अपने लिए पर्सनल, शॉपिंग वगैरह वगैरह सब. एंड ऑल्सो लाइक मुझे मेकअप का शौक था, तो इफ आई हैव टू बाय दैट एंड एवरीथिंग 5,000 में करना था, which is good amount, I'm not saying I'm not complaining, वो बहुत अच्छा amount है, मेरा सब गुजारा हो जाता था उसमें. So from that 5,000, I used to initially before YouTube spend about 3 to 3,500 बाहर खाने में, बाहर friends के साथ जाने में या friends पे ऐसा, and 1,500 में कुछ makeup खरीद लेती थी. So I switched that budget and I made it 3,500 for buying makeup, buying like saving up for my camera, like saving a little, like I should literally save 100-200 rupees to be able to someday buy equipment, because starting में मैं अपने friend की camera borrow करके करती थी. So that 2,000-3,000 से I should buy makeup every month and be able to review, create makeup looks and everything. Starting में I had like one eyeliner, one lipstick, every चीज का एक 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 product था मेरे पास, और फिर वहां से I have built up my makeup kit ऐसा थोड़ा 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 करके, and then जब आने लगा 1.5-2 साल बाद पैसा थोड़ा थोड़ा करके, I started saving and got my camera. That is how I've made my investment. It's been a very long journey. Like 3 saal tak I was only dependent on that pocket money and like trying to save up and make ends meet when it comes to my channel. But yeah, that's how I started. So Chavi asks me, how did you recover from your breakup? My breakup was very mutual. Mera khud ka bhi decision tha usme. Initially I didn't deal with it well. I was very very depressed. I was not in depression, but I was definitely taking the hit very badly. काफी रोना धोना हुआ था, बट आई न्यू कि मुझे वापस नहीं जाना है. मतलब आई हैड टू मूव फॉरवर्ड, आगे ही देखना है. एंड माई फ्रेंड वॉज रियली हेल्पफुल. लाइक माई फ्रेंड हैज सैड एंड लिसन टू मी क्राई एंड क्राई एंड क्राई एवरी नाइट. लाइक पूरा दिन मैं काम करती थी, बहुत काम करती थी, सो मच हो के मैं थक जाती थी और मुझे सोना ही था. बट देन एट नाइट जब वो सब लाइक सोचने लगो एंड इट स्टार्ट्स कमिंग इन योर माइंड, आई यूज टू ओनली वेंट इट आउट टू हर एंड गो टू स्लीप. And that was a routine I should follow for a month, 2 months, 3 months. And then someday I felt like कुछ बचा ही नहीं रोने के लिए, तो I moved on. Are there any major failures in your life? How did they help you grow? Not major failures as such. Everything in my life I've taken as a stepping stone to learn more. My health has always been a downfall for me. Like मेरे ambitions बहुत ज़्यादा है, but मेरी health कभी cooperate नहीं करती है. मुझे काफ़ी health conditions है जो has pulled me down in life, but every time I emerge stronger is what I feel, because I try to do my best to come out of it and I take it एंड दैट इज व्हाई आई ओनली लिव इन द मोमेंट यू नो बिकॉज माई हेल्थ इज सो अनसर्टेन कि कभी भी कुछ भी हो सकता है तो माइट इज वेल मेक द मोस्ट ऑफ व्हाट इट इज नाउ व्हाट डू यू फील वाज द हार्डेस्ट टाइम ऑफ योर लाइफ माइन वाज व्हेन I was not being diagnosed with any disease. I was very sick, very very sick. मतलब अचानक से I got a fever one day and I fell sick. Like in a week's time, I fell on bed. So bad. Like I was so weak. इतनी कमजोर हो गई थी. मतलब जो मतलब देख रहे हो ना मैं कितनी फुर्तीली हूँ normally. I was not myself at all. Like my parents were worried. My family was worried. I was only weak on the bed. मेरे से phone भी नहीं देखा जाता था. Movie नहीं देखी जाती थी. ऐसे करंट्स पास होते थे बॉडी में क्या क्या लाइक आई वॉज सो अनवेल वीक फटीग्ड टायर्ड एंड आई वेंट टू डॉक्टर आफ्टर डॉक्टर आफ्टर डॉक्टर बेस्ट डॉक्टर्स इन बॉम्बे एंड नोबडी को डायग्नोज मी लिटरली नोबडी बहुत बहुत डॉक्टर के चक्कर के 6 महीना आई वॉज ओनली सिक विथ नो डायग्नोसिस इट वॉज द वर्स्ट हार्डेस्ट पीरियड ऑफ माई टाइम एंड माई लाइफ एंड इवेंचुअली वी वेंट टू अ न्यूरोलॉजिस्ट डायग्नोज माई सेल्फ विथ फाइब्रोमायल्जिया गॉट द करेक्ट मेडिकेशन लाइफ मूव्ड ऑन फ्रॉम देयर बट या दैट वॉज That was, that was a period of my life. I think the last question for tonight is going to be any bad experience in friendship or relationship I had and what did I learn from it. I have had a couple of bad experiences in friendship, not relationship because mera ek hi tha. Wo maine tumko bata diya hai. But friendship mein rahe hain. I think friendships are very beautiful when they start but they don't necessarily always have to be that way. This is what I've realized ke Whoever is adding to your life today might not add in the same way later because aap log dono evolve hoge aur same way mein evolve ho zaruri nahi hai and if that person is evolving in a different tangent and you're in a different tangent and it's not meeting anywhere there are only clashes there is no support happening like today all of my friends are very different from me they are all in different journeys of life in different paths and different personalities nobody I can say identifies as the same personality as me but we all support each other what each other is doing, keep in touch, like, you know, keep motivating each other to do better no matter what they are doing with their lives. And even if we have downfalls, we pick each other up. So I've had friendships where I've not experienced that and I've felt really like, you know, being with that person was making me feel bad about myself, shit about myself, were only fighting about petty, silly things, was not growing. Like a lot of times I am growing, but a person is pulling me back. Aisa hua hai. So I think it was very difficult for me. It's happened to me twice to move on from friendships because I treat my friends as my everything. My friends are my world and I give them a lot of me. So bahut bahut mushkil raha hai. But then with time and with the help of other friends, I've moved on. I've grown and evolved as a person and realized ki just because that person was not growing with me, meri galti nahi hai. Uski bhi galti nahi hai. Chhod do. Like, you know, forgive and forget is a motto that honestly helps so much with a relationship. With a breakup in friendship, with everything. See, if you can just forgive that person, agar tum grudge rakhoge na, to wo tumko hold back karega, puri life hold back karega, wo insan ki taraf. Don't keep a grudge, just forgive that person mentally. Don't actually tell them, ke, oh, I'm forgiving you for things you've not apologized for. Don't do that. Just mentally forgive them for everything you felt hurt for and move on, forget. That's it. That's all the life gab you get from Sara today. I hope you guys enjoyed this very, very personal chit-chatty video. If you did, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. Today, I'm not giving any specific Sara Squad shout-out because it goes to all of you beautiful people who asked me such interesting questions and made me have this very fun chat with y'all. I hope you guys enjoyed. I will see you tomorrow with a fresh new video. Bye, guys. Love you.